In a previous course, we covered an overview of Explore. As a quick review, Explore is a collection of advanced analysis techniques that go beyond standard reports to uncover more insights about customer behavior. Explorations give you access to data and analytical techniques that aren't available in standard reports, such as funnels and pathing. You can use Explore to answer a wide variety of questions, such as which channels drove the most site engagement and key events on your site, where users might be dropping off in your signup or checkout flow funnels, or what are the most common paths a customer might take through your site. Since we previously covered the freeform technique, let's start where we left off by diving deeper here to check for any anomalies in our dataset. We'll start with a simple freeform report that is looking at page path and screen class as a dimension and views, sessions, and active users as metrics. Once we have a table we're satisfied with, we'll go ahead and duplicate this report by clicking the drop-down arrow on the tab and choosing Duplicate. We'll do this so we can maintain a table report while also digging into a new visualization type. Once we're in the duplicate copy, we'll change the visualization type to a line chart. Ensure the anomaly detection slider is turned on. Doing so immediately shows us there's a problem in the dataset on September 27th, 2023. We see here that there are 77,000 views of the slash basket page, when GA4 expected to see about 10,000 views, which is a 654% increase in views for this particular page. Next, let's right-click on the anomaly bubble and choose Create Segment from Selection. This will create a segment that includes all views that match the criteria that the page path and screen class match slash basket and occurred on September 27th. Once we save this segment, we can go back to our original table report and apply it. Next, let's add the operating system with version dimension to the report to see if we can see any indicators of spam traffic. It does look like there's a large amount of traffic coming from Macintosh Intel 13.5 and 13.6. To be sure, let's compare this date to the same day in the previous week to see if this traffic is part of what led to the spike. We can immediately see that there was no traffic from those OS versions that previous week, which indicates that this is likely one of the culprits of bot or spam traffic. Now we know that the traffic spike we saw that day is not all legitimate traffic, and that to ensure we are only reporting on traffic that is intentional, we'd want to filter out the OS versions we've seen here. To do so, we'll use a filter on the bottom of the settings pane to exclude versions that contain Intel 13. Applying just this one filter, we see that views were reduced from 440,000 to 163,000 in the same time period, which is a significant reduction in unwanted traffic. Note that to ensure we remove all of the unwanted traffic, we'd want to continue this exercise to find more illegitimate looking traffic. But for the purposes of this example, we'll stop here. Next, let's take a look at funnels in Explore and walk through a step-by-step exercise to learn how to use this technique. Funnels are a great tool to help you understand how users are progressing through a specific set of criteria or steps, such as a checkout funnel. Using the Google Merchandise Store demo account, let's build a funnel for users who have come to the Merchandise Store website homepage, then added an Android product to their cart, added their billing information, and then completed the purchase. Open up a new tab in the Explore report and select Funnel Exploration. Once in the funnel report, the first thing you'll want to do is click on the edit icon in the step section to start building the funnel. The first step will be a view of the website homepage. Give the step a name, in this case, homepage view, and then choose add new condition and select page path and screen class. Select exactly matches and then select the condition for the homepage, which is a forward slash. Click add step. Step two will then be an add to cart event with a condition that the item brand contains Android. Notice that the line between the steps says is indirectly followed by. This means that the user might take other actions between steps in 1 and 2 and will still be included in this funnel as reaching step 2. If you were to switch this to directly followed by, then the next step must occur immediately after the previous step without any intervening actions. An event such as a scroll could count as an intervening action. So we'd recommend keeping this as is indirectly followed by unless you are doing a very specific analysis. The next step will be adding payment information. For this, we'll search for the event called Add Payment Info and select that for the step condition. Finally, we'll add our last step, which is the purchase event. Again, we'll search for the event called Purchase and select that as our step condition. Once we've finalized building our funnel steps, click Apply to use these conditions for the funnel. Now that we have a 4-step funnel built, we can interact with it in many different ways, such as adding segments, breaking it down, making it open or closed, filtering it, and more. Let's go ahead and add the device category dimension as a breakdown on top of this funnel. You can do so by either double-clicking the dimension from the variables pane or dragging and dropping it onto the settings pane. In this example, it looks like a large portion of the traffic coming to the merchandise store homepage is from mobile, but that starting around step 2, desktop traffic accounts for the majority of the add to carts all the way through purchases. Knowing this, we may want to focus on desktop traffic. You can do this in a number of ways, such as segmenting for desktop traffic or adding a filter. A quick and simple way to narrow this down would be to right-click on the desktop line under step 1 and choose Include Only These Users. This quickly narrows down the funnel to only desktop users and gives us a consolidated view of them so that we can do further analysis if desired. The last technique I'd like to cover is the pathing technique. This technique is useful to see how users move through various pages or events on your site and can lead to an understanding of paths or funnels you may not have realized are common behavior. A useful application of the pathing technique is to path backwards from the beginning of a known funnel. For example, once a user adds to cart, the funnel is pretty straightforward. However, knowing what a user did before they added to cart can be a really useful piece of insight to help you optimize the customer journey and encourage more users to enter into your funnel. Open up a new tab in your exploration and choose Path Exploration. Then, in the upper right-hand corner, click on Start Over. This will open up a screen where you can choose either a starting point or an ending point. Click on Ending Point and choose Event Name as the node type. Now, we'll search for the event name of Add to Cart. This will then open up a backwards path ending with the Add to Cart event. By default, the next step you interact with will default to event name, since that's where you started. But in the pathing technique, you can switch back and forth from page name or page path to event name for each step. Go ahead and change this step from event name to page path. This will now show us the top pages that users added to cart from. You can continue to path backwards from there to understand the journey to those high converting pages. In this case, it looks like the 25th birthday page is driving quite a bit of interest and action to add to cart. Knowing this, perhaps the Google Merchandise Store should consider surfacing creative for this birthday campaign more prominently on their site. So as you've seen throughout this lesson, you can use Explore to answer many different types of questions, dive deeper onto things like anomalies, track shopping behavior and sales funnels, understand user journeys across your site or app, and so much more. Try using Explore to deep dive on your business questions and gain valuable insight on your marketing and business efforts.